Okay. So take a look. This S&P 500 on a 3-minute chart. And this is what it looks like on a 5-minute chart. Okay? So I want you to take note of your Friday's closing and Sunday's open. Okay? I want you to take note of that one. Kung nalilito kayo on a 1-minute on a 3-minute chart, go to zoom in. Go to your 1-minute chart. Narito yung music. There you go. And now, I want you to plot the Friday's closed. There you go. Name that one as a Friday's closing. And go to your Sunday's opening. There you go. And now, I want you to plot your Fibonacci inside of that zone. Drag that across to that Friday's closing. And find that 50% consequent encouragement right around here. And now you can delete the Fibonacci you just plotted. And after that words, go to your 15-minute chart, double click the scale, and zoom out. And now you'll see where the market rests. Naintindihan? So copy ba lahat? So anyways, lahat ba meron na? Okay? Lahat ba nakita na yung gusto ko ipa-plot sa kanila? I-annotate nyo na ba yan dyan sa mga charts ninyo? So, if your charts looks like this, then you're good to go. Okay? So, Sir Kim, anong gusto mo makita sa market natin na to? So, anyways, if yung tool nga na sabi mo, Sir Kim, on a weekly chart, meron tayong volume imbalance na na-create on 4219 on 60. excuse me. Okay? So, I want to see the price move towards to that high on 4216.60. Gusto ko siyang tumaas right around dito this week. I'm not saying na ngayon yung mangyayari mamayang gabi. Okay? Don't take my word out of context. Ayoko makuha niya ito mamayang gabi or even tomorrow. I want to get this high this week. How can you say so, Sir Kim? How can you say so? So now, if we're going to Dixie, okay, we're going to Dixie, I believe may pinlat tayo dito on a weekly chart before. Type Y in the chat if you still remember this song. Okay, so I want Dixie nang pupuntahan niya itong clear zone natin right around here or puntahan itong mga sell side liquidity below here, resting below here. Yan ang gusto kong mangyari kay Dixie, and it will not do that tonight or even tomorrow. It takes time because this is a weekly time frame. So I want to see a reaction on Dixie papunta dito sa zones na to throughout this week. Not today or not tomorrow, this week. Okay, so take a look at your S&P 500. Siyempre, very common sense. Diba? So if we see Dixie fell down, we want to see S&P 500 to go up and maybe break these highs. Who knows? I don't know. But one thing for sure, ito lang masasabi ko sa inyo lahat. If yung S&P 500 natin went up below or above that volume imbalance, nakikita nyo to? Nakikita nyo tong top to bottom na to? Right around here. Kailangan nyo lagyan to ng annotation. Lagyan nyo siya ng box or line. You don't want the price to go above that zone from that top to that bottom. Huwag niyong makikita yung price na babasagin to. If mabasa niya tong zones na to, then definitely nasa completely reversal mode for S&P 500, then ano yun? Ano ibig sabihin ng Sir Kim? I'm expecting this one is still bearish, guys. Bearish pa rin tong si S&P 500. Tandaan nyo. Napaka-bearish pa rin ito ni S&P 500. If you zoom out, take a look at this one. If you zoom out, a run on a higher time frame is a trend on a lower time frame. Now, yes, I get it. this is a bearish momentum to the downside. But again, gusto ko makakita ng respecting dito sa zone sa to. Ayoko na mabasag nyo to. If and only if mababasag to ni S&P 500 itong Sunday's close, Sunday's open and Friday's close, then definitely the price of S&P 500 wants to go up. Possible basagin niya itong zone or puntahan niya itong mga zones na to. But again, not quickly, slowly. Okay? So possible that will be a run to the upside for S&P 500 if and only if babasagin na natin itong Sundays to Fridays na to dati pa way back noong August, noong August 2022. Maintindihan? Take note of that. That is way back August. Almost a year now. Pag pupunta na tayo August, that's almost a year. So, ayokong pumunta yung pressure dyan because pag pumunta yung pressure natin ni S&P 500 dito, it will change a lot. Possible sumabog to. Now, Sir Kim, I want a Bitcoin explanation regarding that one. Siyempre, it will do the same thing. Magsasawa kayo, pero it will do the same thing. Alam nyo yan. Alam na alam nyo yan. Okay? Alam nyo yan. Ibig sabihin, Sir Kim, pala, is kung itong S&P 500 natin went up above here or pumunta dito yan sa August 15, 2022 na volume imbalance niya right around here, ibig sabihin si Bitcoin is possible sumabog din. Diba? And syempre, isa lang ang sagot ko niyan. If ganun ang gagawin ni S&P 500, if and only if ganun ang gagawin ni S&P 500, then yes. Walang secret doon. There's no secret. If S&P 500 went up to that zone, for sure, Bitcoin will do the same thing. Now, let's go to Bitcoin. This is my Bitcoin on a 15 minutes chart. We have a support area right around 29,788. That clear zone right there. Okay, so S&P 500 dropped kahapon nung 8:15 p.m. I didn't see this one. Okay, I didn't even check my charts. So now, I want to see kung kaya bang basagin ni Bitcoin. Ito. No, I didn't say na that's an end wog. Okay. That's a gap to fill para kay Bitcoin or the 15 minutes chart. If I want to see S&P 500 moving up to that 15 minute zone, tignan niyo to ha. Imagine niyo parehas lang sila, pero hindi ibig sabihin ganun din sila. Okay? They have a similarities. It's just bumagsak lang to. Okay? So, I want to see S&P 500 holding this zone or going above. Okay? Then, Bitcoin will do the same thing. Possible, tumaas siya dito. Paganyan. And dito magsisimula ang aking view to check Bitcoin. Until then, hindi ko i-check sa Bitcoin. Until then, hindi ako magte-trade kay Bitcoin. Eh, Sir Kim, what if pumunta naman dito yung price, then ano magiging trade mo for Bitcoin? Tama ba? Is that a question na meron kayo on your head right now? Now, if we're going to 2-hourly on a higher time frame for Bitcoin, take a look at that. Nag-hold siya dito sa support and resistance na to. Now, let's go to weekly time frame. Ano ba sabi ko sa inyo way back before, guys? Do you still remember? Bitcoin is aiming for that high of 31,482. Type Y in the chat if you still remember. Bitcoin is aiming to target that highs right around here. And syempre, very obvious naman, if and only if basagin to ni Bitcoin, you can see some relevancy movement na ginagamit natin kay S&P 500 dito kay Bitcoin. So, it might go up somewhere around in these zones. Not here. Basag na to. natamaan na to. So second attempt to that breaking that 50% level will cause a lot of damage, then Bitcoin can move up. But yeah, hindi ko na-expect na possible. No. Ito? No. Okay? No. So again, ito lang yung pinaka-safe to say ko para masabi na possible umakyat si Bitcoin. This is the edge for me na possible akyatin yung Bitcoin. If si Bitcoin naman ay umangat somewhere around in these zones, hanggang dito sa zones na to, the 33K to 32K, then possible magkakaroon tayo ng movement dyan, pag ganyan, then massively dump. And, tignan nyo mabuti ha. Do you still remember, guys, kung anong month ko sinabi na possible may mangyayaring kaguluhan sa market? Do you still remember? Kailan yun? August will be the effect. Pero kailan yung mangyayari? Ano ba bago mag-August? Correct. July. Now, let's take a look kung nasa ng July. June. And then, July. Punta tayo sa first week and then last week ng July para mag-enter ng August. There you go. Let's take note. There you go. Okay? So, now let's take a look. This gap right around here extended to the right. What do you see? Right here. Extended to the right. Now, bakit ayun ang ginamit mo, Sir Kim? I can see a relevancy that the price is respecting that zone. Imagine there's a 50% level on that zone, and same exact thing with this volume imbalance you see here. It's respecting it. So now, I'm expecting that the movement can go as high as in these two zones right around here. If and only if, tandaan niyo yung word na sinasabi ko, don't take my word out of context, if and only if, babasagin natin to. But again, this is my plan. Ang gusto ko lang is, makita ang pressure na pumunta dito, then I'm done. Okay? Then I'm done. What do you mean by I'm done? That is the time that I will check Bitcoin to what? To get ready for my June, or in July, and maybe in August market movement. No, I'm not expecting Bitcoin to go up around 100,000 to 50,000 to up to 64K. No, I'm not. I'm dumping this Bitcoin once it goes above in these zones. If and only if, okay? If and only if. Okay? If and only if. Now, Sir Kim, is Bitcoin going to reach that one tonight? No. I'm not. I'm not expecting Bitcoin to get that high tonight or even tomorrow or even next week. No. Again, you still have how much? Let's take a look at the date range. We still have 105 days. Matagal pa yon, and 15 weeks. Okay? 15 weeks para malaman yon. And that 15 weeks kasama na diyan yung pag-transition natin to August. Pero how about the first week of July? We only have 11 weeks left. 11 weeks left, which is countdown to 77 days. Okay. Yes, sir, Kim, possible ba umakyat sa Bitcoin natin papuntang 50K to 64K? For me, wala. Okay? For me, I don't know. It's just wala. Okay? For me, wala. There's no way na possible umakyat sa Bitcoin dito sa zones na to. Why? Because Bitcoin is not getting the same volume na meron siya way back before. volume is not receiving the same volume that it did last few years. Why? Eh, syempre, matalino yun yung mga tao. Naging, yung iba tumalino, yung iba nag-exit, yung iba nawala, yung iba natalo ng sobrang laki, then na-trauma, then hindi na bumalik. That's why, hindi nyo na sila makita ngayon. Why? Maybe they end up losing their savings. Yung iba, baon sa utang. That's why. Okay? That's why. So for me, ang possible na mangyari kay Bitcoin is it can go as high as 33 to 35k. Last na siguro yung 36k or 35,999. So for me, that's the last one. Makikita nyo yung price magre-respect siya sa zones na to. Right around 35k to 36k zone ni S&P 5, ni Bitcoin once na tumama yan dyan. Even only, babasagin lang natin to. Okay, so possible this is the movement I want to see on Bitcoin. I want it to consolidate a little bit to get this high of 31,482. Then, went back down a little bit. I'm not expecting it to go down below hanggang 21k. No, I'm not. Okay, hindi na po pwedeng mangyari yon. Okay? Hindi po pwede mangyari na bumaba po si Bitcoin bago ma-reach itong highs. No. Ibig sabihin, hindi po pwede gumanto si Bitcoin tsaka tataas ang ganyan. No. Hindi po. Okay? Binibigay ko sa inyo yung concept na meron ako sa utak ko, and this is not the option. You don't want to see the price going down to that zone quickly. Kasi, there's a building momentum. Kailangan niya makuha to dahan-dahan nang hindi bumabalik sa zone sa to, neto, and neto. And guess what? After neto makuha, yung 35 to 36K dito sa zone sa to, or even hindi to nga lang eh, dito sa zone sa to, then the price will massively go to the downside. Okay? The price will go to the downside. Now, I want you to remember your names. I want you to remember the list of the names na meron kayo dito ngayon, yung mga kaklase ninyo. I want you to remember your names. Why? I will upload this one on YouTube. Okay? I will upload this one on YouTube and you'll see yourself 77 days and 105 days from now that you've anticipated this market na binigay ko sa inyo. Ngayon pa lang, today is marked Monday, April 17, 2023, 4:15 p.m. So now, tignan nyo. Okay? Makikita ninyo. Okay? So I want you to remember your seatmate, classmate, dito sa private space na meron tayo ngayon. Then, yeah, I'll be seeing you guys on 105 days and 77 days from now on. I want you to remember these zones na pinanotate ko sa inyo. I want you to remember that. Okay? Until then, talk to you next time. Okay? I'll talk to you next time. But again, binigay ko na sa inyo lahat ng possible kung maibigay na idea sa inyo. Okay? There you go. Now, okay. Are you going to trade Bitcoin, Sir Kim? Of course, I will. Di ba nga sabi ko nga sa inyo, if and only if mangyari yan, uunahan pa kita. Uunahan pa kita. Okay? Mauunahan kita and there's no way na malilate ako dun. Uunahan kita. Siguro makakasabay ka lang sa amin if and only if alam mong nakashort na kami. Pero guess what? Matagal na kami nakashort. Parang ganon. Okay? Late ka na. You're only getting 2%. We're getting 77% to 100% or more than 100%. But again, I'm just saying, ito yung possible na mangyari sa movement. I want you to remember the dates, July and August. May nakita nagtanong kanina, what if mapaaga yung dilubyo? No, there's no way na mapaaga yan. Why? There's an algorithm set for that one. They schedule that one to release on July, something July. And the effect will be on August. Actually, July nga magkakaroon ng effect. Then I want you to see the August, kung ano yung tsura ng August. Okay? So, yeah. So, again, This is Bitcoin, S&P 500, and Dixie, a breakdown. Okay? A breakdown. And same exact thing, syempre, kung gusto nyo maging, ano, let's say for example, masyado kayong conservative, then take note of July and then August. And go to your weekly chart, and you'll see what I'm talking about. We only have 15 weeks left. I don't know. So, yeah. So, tonight, guys, I didn't have a bias for tonight's trade na mangyayari tonight. So, I'll be sticking on gold muna. Okay? I'll be sticking on gold. So, gold will be highs. It will target the highs possible. Okay? But ito yung magiging trade scope prior sa New York session natin tonight. So, I want to trade gold tonight, today, this session, afternoon session natin ngayon sa Pilipinas. So, si gold muna ang aking pagdidiskitahan, and I will try to check the other pairings na meron tayo sa Forex. Okay? So, yun yung mga iti-trade ko tonight. I will not trade S&P 500, not until I saw a breakup right around here. Sir King, what if it break down below here, then I will target these zones of here, and even here, and even here. So, ulitin ko lang ha. Ayoko makita si S&P 500 to go down below hanggang dito. Or even in this zone. Okay? Or even in that low. Ayoko na po makita si Bitcoin, si S&P 500 dito. Why? Ibig sabihin, mahihirapan tayo makakita ng break level dito kay Dixie this week. Naintindihan? There you have it. Okay. You have the price review for this week. I did cover dito sa live natin na to. Kinover ko na lahat sa inyo until July to August. Kung ano possible na mangyari sa market. So, for sure, hindi kayo mali-left behind na ito. Okay? Sa marunong naman gumamit ng NMOG, alam nyo naman na ibig sabihin yan. Diba? Alam nyo naman na ibig sabihin yan. Okay, good. And now, yung mga nakita ko sa Twitter, okay, may mga nakita ko sa Twitter na nag-submit ng assignments nila. Okay. There you go. Nakita ko yung mga nag-submit ng assignment dito. And then, if I go to my page, mga niretweet ko. This is what you're going to play mamayang session natin. Again, magla-live ako. Okay? Magla-live ako tonight. Then I want you to trade kung ano yung mga sinabi nyo sa assignment ko. Assignment nyo dito. Okay? There you go. Naintindihan? So, again, friendly reminder lang po, no? So, sa lahat po ng mga hindi nag-submit ng assignment na sa Twitter, I will try to remove you from my Discord channel, both channels. Ibaban ko na kayo dito sa both channels natin. So, you have until today to submit your assignment. If hindi kayo makapag-submit, I don't care. It means you're lazy. Again, ang tagal ko nang pinasabi yan. Try to achieve that man. And then, I don't want you to have a, you know, they want you to argue with me. Kung hindi mo naiintindihan, pwede ka naman magtanong. But again, you didn't do it. So, that tells a lot. Tamad ka. Okay? Tamad ka. Simpleng bagay na pinapagawa, hindi mo magawa. Then, how can I tell kung kaya mo rin sumunod? Okay? So, if simpleng bagay, hindi mo magawa, then that tells a lot, then you're on your own. Okay? You're on your own. Okay? So, sa mga nagsabi ng assignment ninyo, okay, you'll have a Discord here, and we're doing a live tonight. Okay? So, again, if you want to reach the gold, if you want to trade the gold, other forex pairs, you can trade it now. But again, don't perform that one on S&P 500 kasi ito yung backup natin. Okay? So, mamayang gabi pa po ito. Okay? Mamayang gabi pa po ito. Okay? Mamayang gabi pa to. So yeah, again, Bitcoin, possible pag-diskitahan ko to. Okay? Again, hindi po ako magte-trade ng Bitcoin not until na bumalik tayo dito sa zones na to na 31,470.93 zones. Gusto ko makuha muna to bago ako makakita ng trade ko sa kanya. Intindihan? So, ganun lang. So, gusto ko una, ulitin ko lang para hindi tayo magkalito ang lahat. Okay, don't take my word out of context. Hindi po ako magte-trade ng Bitcoin not until matamaan natin to. And then, gusto ko makita kung nasan yung S&P 500 natin that time. Okay, if we go to weekly time frame, kung nasan to, gusto ko makita kung nasan to. Naintindihan? Gusto ko muna makita kung nasan yung S&P 500 natin bago ko i-trade tong si Bitcoin na to. Again, I will not trade to short it, I will not try to short it, I will not try to long it. Gusto ko muna makita kung ano itsura nito, then that tells a lot. Kasi ito nga yung sinasabi ko sa inyo, di ba? Gusto ko muna makita kung ano mangyayari dito sa stop na to and to that lows na to. If we see a good rejection to that phase, then I'm good to go. I will try to short Bitcoin back to its origin. These lows, these lows, these lows. Or even, go to monthly time frame. I don't know. Check nyo na lang. Okay? I-check nyo na lang. I don't know. Okay, I don't know. Just check it. Just check it. Ganun lang kasimple. Okay. But anyways, okay, for now, I want you to enjoy your time. Okay, enjoy your afternoon. So, pwede kayong matulog, pwede kayong kumain kung anong gusto nyo gawin. Okay, magpahinga kayo kung gusto nyo para mag-ready kayo mamaya ng New Year session. But again, I will trade gold and other forex pairs now on my Bingix account. So yeah, I'll be seeing you guys later on sa YouTube channel para makapag-live tayo. And again, that's very much it. I hope you're having a great day so far. I hope may nakuha kayong knowledge dito sa pag-topic natin ng market natin this coming week or even months from now. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Hope you're having a great day so far. And as always, talk to you tomorrow, guys. Actually, later pala. Tomorrow tulad. Okay? So, bye-bye. Thank you so much. Peace out.